If you have never used one of our devices with 100G or even faster interfaces, then it might seem like you just have no use for them because they are not compatible with your older devices. But that is not the case. Let me show you how you could connect a 100G interface to 25G, 10G, and even 1G interfaces. The first thing that we need to acknowledge here is that the letter Q in these SFP standard names like QSFP28 stand for quad. It literally means that the 100G interface is made up of four SFP28 interfaces. So backwards compatibility is not as difficult as it might seem at first. For example, you could get a generic optical breakout cable such as this one. Then at one end, you could use a QSFP28 module such as this one, and then at the other end you could use four SFP28 interfaces such as this. Then another option, you could use a DAC breakout cable such as this one. At one end, again, you have QSFP28, and at the other end you have four SFP28 interfaces. This particular cable that we make is also compatible with SFP Plus interfaces, so we could use it to connect these two devices. When plugging in the cables at this end, pay attention to the numbers on them, because they should be numbered from 1 to 4. I plugged in number 1, and now for this setup to start working, we would still have to change some configuration on both of these devices. If we open up the interfaces section on the CRS504, we can see that the QSFP28 interfaces consist of groups of four, so even logically the 100G interfaces are already split up, and we can easily change settings for all of them independently. The first interface is the one we are looking for. In the Ethernet tab, we have to first disable auto negotiation, and then we can change the speed. Currently, you get a large list of options that is not filtered for your module or cable, so you just have to know which options you can use. All copper DAC cables will require one of the base CR options. By default, 100G DACs try to use this 100G base CR4 mode, because it lets the four component interfaces work together as one. It is a special speed setting that you can find only on the first of the four interfaces, but for a breakout cable, it is not good. We're going to select the 10G base CR mode because we have a 10G SFP Plus interface at the other end. Then we have to go to the RB5009 interfaces and apply the exact same speed setting to the SFP Plus interface. You should see a link being established immediately after you hit apply. Alright, that is how you can hook up 10G to QSFP28 and still have three 25G interfaces available. But I have to show you one more thing. You can also get adapters like this. It's the QSFP28 form factor, but as a whole for an SFP28 interface. It simply slides in. And now this will use the first from the four available QSFP group interfaces as a simple 25G interface. Let's hook it up. As soon as we plug it in, it starts working, a link is established. But remember that the speed setting we chose was designed for DAC cables, so even though it works, we should change to a setting that is fine-tuned for optics. We can use the 10G base SRLR. As soon as we apply it at both ends, we get a working, reliable link. Now, the adapter and the SFP28 modules I used here are compatible with 1G speeds as well. It is quite a sad downgrade from 100 to 1, but you can. The only nuance would be that you have to select the 1G base X mode at both ends. But other than that, it is the same thing. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.